sisters.
Good day to you, partner. I'm Eve, and I can already tell that I'll be your best friend in this forsaken camp.
Sweet Solo here, aka the Skeleton King. So Landis III has continued his journey into madness, and he is still playing his Immortal Necromancer, which is high defense, 100% CDR, and then also using an Act 1 Merc. I want to talk about this for just a little bit. The reason Landis, I guess, uses an Act 1 Merc now is it turns out we don't need Doom anymore. It's actually possible we never really needed Doom. Maybe I should explain this even a little more. Yes, the Cage of the Unsullied, whatever it's goddamn called, has a lot of defense. But Toadflax and hardcore players were apparently right. High defense really, really helps. So even if you cannot afford Cage of the Unsullied, you should actually concern yourself with the defense values of your gear. Landis will show at the end of this video that he only gets hit by 34% of enemies in this map. So if you combine getting hit by only 34% of enemies with a ludicrously high bone armor, with very high max res, and 8-9 minions surrounding you, basically it means he never gets hit. By the way, this map has a lot of max health, and he is not one-shotting everything. Landis III lies to me, okay? He says that he can run maps with this high max health and everything dies in one poison Nova cast. They clearly don't, but we gotta look at the math more, because it looks like he's not killing anything but the crawlers and the flayers in one poison Nova cast. By the way, I'm actually really impressed to see how often she procs lower resist. It's kind of wild, to be honest. And I'm actually really impressed that he actually made this build work. And once we realized how important, like, he's going to show off his defense. Anyways, once we realize this, you kind of don't need Doom anymore. Now, could you run Act 3 instead? Sure. Act 3 could give you a place to use in Exile, and then you could have your Cleansing IG. So there's always the idea of not running Act 1. It's just that Landis is doing this to basically run every single map in the game, even a map with poison immunes like Canyon, and killing every enemy. By the way, for how high the max health is and a not very good map for poison, as you can see, I'm actually pretty impressed with his clear speed. Ooh, puzzle piece. So what else can we talk about in this video? Well, besides the idea of what mercs you want, and Emilio is still probably your best bet for single target boss damage, although I do want to continue my Act 5 merc DPS checks one of these days. By the way, I'm just going to say it here, Whirlwind merc is better than Might merc, okay? Just always. Alright, done. There's something interesting about what he did with his pus spitter, and that is he put Cham runes in it. Now, what are you going to actually put in her pus spitter if it runs 4 sockets, right? Well, you could put in jewels for defense or FHR and things like that, health, you know, just survivability. But what he put inside of them is Cham runes, and Cham runes freeze targets. Now, he thinks that there's an issue with it. By the way, he's got a Rathma book, which is just pisses me off. But anyways, he thinks that it's actually not proccing very often, and he's actually concerned that the minions are causing stickiness. So this is the second thing I want to talk about in this video, because some players might not understand what this is, and that you don't have to worry about it anymore. In old seasons of PD2, and I'm assuming in LOD as well, summons could get stuck on one another when you teleported. So a summons plus mercs plus revives, basically they'd have to, whoever was on like top of the stack, so to speak, would have to move before any of the other minions could move. And they wouldn't do anything. Literally, they would actually, they wouldn't even attack an enemy right in front of them. That has been fixed. Now, it may look like sometimes they don't move, but that is just a visual desync. The enemies or the summons are moving around and doing whatever it is summons do. Does that mean they're doing something you want them to do? Hey, I'm the Skeleton King, and sometimes these guys don't do what I want them to do. Also, besides having a 10-frame idle, if they are caught in an AI cycle, which means they haven't aggroed a new target, they can just run around, do nothing, and then go, oh, I want to attack this. So there's other things summons can be doing that aren't useful. But what they aren't is being stuck on one another. All of these enemies, once you finish warping, are trying to do whatever it is their AI is telling them to accomplish, including the mercenary. So I've actually seen a whole bunch of enemies being frozen and even getting popped when they die. Now, I don't know how extra useful this is, but it was very cool that Landis actually had the wherewithal to go, I'm running a pus spitter on an Act 1 merc. She already never dies, and by the way, I can confirm this. Act 1 mercs, if you have an Exile aura up, and or Defiance aura from Exile, wow, poor paladins. I don't even call them by the name of the aura anymore. I just say the rune word they're on. That poor class has no identity. That's another topic for a different video. What are you going to give her in these sockets? Well, what if we had her freeze enemies? It's like, could she do anything more useful than that? I don't think so. Well, that's really the only things I wanted to talk about. Skelly King out for now. GG. Enjoy some tunes.
Play with us, Daddy. Forever.